What's good, YouTube? It's your girl, Asia.
And it's your boy, BJ.
Back in the building.
Back in effect. Back like we never left. Y'all, we appreciate y'all for tuning in. Y'all go ahead and come on in and have a seat. Today, we're going to be jumping into Roy Orbison. The title of the song is Crying. This is actually a suggestion via donation. This was actually suggested, highly requested in one of our lives as well. But we just never got around to doing it. So we're going to jump into it today.
Oh, yeah, it was. I forgot about that. Yeah. If you haven't already, be sure you head over to my vlog channel. I'm Just Asia. Check out the content. Mm. I also have a reaction channel. I'm Still Asia. Dropping fire reactions, y'all. The links will be in the description for both of those channels. So make sure y'all check them out.
Actually, definitely check it out. If y'all are new to this channel, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Smash that notification bell so you do not miss any videos from Asia and BJ. But, yay, it's been a little minute since we had a chance to actually get into this one because from the live, I think this was like the second runner-up or something like that.
Yeah.
Second runner-up like twice. So I was like, hey, we got to double back around, hop into Roy Orbison, and just check it out.
Okay.
But you ready?
Yeah, let's go and get into it, y'all. Wait, let me get my ashiness first. Okay. All right, let's go.
I was all right for a while. I could smile for a while. But I saw you last night. You held my hand so tight. As you stop to say hello, or you wish me well, you couldn't tell that I've been crying over you, crying over you. Then you said so long, left me standing.
I like the simplicity of this song, though. You know what's really like weird to me, I guess, in comparison to like today's music, when you hear like, you know, depressing type of music talking about crying and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. It really sounds like they crying when they actually singing the song. Almost like in a whining sense with him. He's just singing the song. He's talking about crying, but he's just singing it. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like the music obviously is giving us more of the emotion than his voice is. But like with today's music, it's like the music is what it is, but then it's the voice that you hear that's doing all the like whining, crying, you know, singing.
Yeah, I kind of feel you on there too. Even with Roy Orbison, like what you're saying as far as like the actual like music part, like it gives you that feeling of like someone's been crying, like you kind of been down in the dumps, not feeling too good today, you know, not at your best today.
Yeah.
But and also he kind of noted where he kind of like came across like maybe like an old flame or someone that he was used to be involved mm-hmm. with, and it's like, you know, all those old memories, all those old feelings have been festered up, and it's like, hey, I'm in my feelings today.
Yeah.
I'm in my feelings today. I thought I was over you, but.
But I'm not.
I thought that I was over you, but it's true, so true. I love you even more than I did before, but darling, what can I do?
Oh, That was Bravo. I gotta get out of Bravo.
Yeah. I like this. This probably isn't like one of my favorite oldies, if I'm being completely honest. But I did like the song. I like his voice. Like I said, the simplicity of the song in general, I think, says a lot. And then what he's talking about. It's just, you know, freaking being in love with somebody. You know what I mean? Like, y'all know I'm a sucker for a love song. But I'm just saying.
Or a heartbreak song.
Yeah, right.
Either or.
One of the two.
Either or.
Yeah.
Yeah, and even with Roy Orbison, with this particular ballad, I felt that like it was more about the song. It's more about, you know, his voice and what he's saying. It wasn't really more all about everything as far as like the instrumentation and things of that nature. Like you had that, you know, obviously in the song as well, but like the focal point of the song is more around his feelings and how he feels in regards to seeing his old flame and how they like rekindled those feelings. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I feel like you said, like the simplicity of the song, like nothing was taken away from this song with the music. Even though like the beat was just repetitive over and over again,
yeah.
It was pretty repetitive. But again, like the simplicity of it, and really it's catered around what he's saying as far as crying and why he's crying,
yeah,
and his and the feeling that it gives him, you know.
Right, right. No, but, I agree.
But like Roy Orbison, he has a very nice voice too, you know.
Yeah.
But again, like that showing like that vulnerable side, you know, back then, like that vulnerable side, it was okay back then to show the vulnerable side. You know, to a woman, or you know what I'm saying?
Oh, I feel like we've seen a lot of that actually. Like probably more than that we hear like today, like in the modern music. Like people don't really confess and be that vulnerable in their feelings over music like that as much. Like unless they talking about fighting, okay, and gangs and war and whatever else. Like that's the only time you hear real passion. But I'm just talking about like love, you know what I mean?
And
like
heartbreak.
Yeah.
Love, heartbreak, and 808s.
I feel like there's a lot of that in country though. Definitely in the country genre, we hear a lot of love songs.
Yeah.
In country music,
definitely.
But that's where I feel like I've heard it the most in the older collection of music that we've listened to.
Yeah, because back then it was okay to be vulnerable.
Yeah.
In the music, especially in the music, like put the pride aside and let's just get to the real feelings. Yeah. You know. But y'all definitely drop some comments. Let us know if there are other Roy Orbison songs that we definitely need to touch on, because this one was good too. And again, like I said, I just love the subject matter.
Yeah, same here. So if y'all enjoyed this video, be sure you give me a big thumbs up. Like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any videos from Asia and BJ. And if ain't nobody told you, I love you. And we're going to see y'all in the next video. Y'all.
Yeah.
Bye.